Now let's discuss about length of path of contact. So we know what is path of contact. So your path of contact is the point traced from beginning of engagement to the end of engagement. So your length of path of contact is nothing but the line, okay, so the line which is normal to the point of contact. If you try to draw a line which is normal to point of contact, and that line, okay, which is intersected by the addendum circle of both the gears. So this line is intersecting the addendum circle of both the gears, and the in-between distance is called the path of length of contact. So according to this diagram, as you can see, so we have pinion, and you have another gear is called a wheel. So all the radius corresponding to pinion is shown in a small letter R, and for this wheel it is shown in capital letter. So the radius of the pinion, okay, addendum, the radius of the addendum circle of the pinion is given by small letter R A, and the radius of addendum circle of the wheel is given by capital R A. And you have the base circle of the pinion, you have the base circle of the wheel, you have the pit circle of the pinion as well as the wheel. As you can see that they are in contact at point P, which is called the pitch point, and the pinion is rotating in clockwise direction, so the wheel rotates in anti-clockwise direction. And the angle made by the normal with respect to a line which is tangent to the pitch circle and passing through the pitch point, so you have the pressure angle. So wherever at the start of engagement, let us the point is called K, okay, the end of engagement of the both the tooths is given by point L. So this normal, okay, this normal, okay, which is to the point of contact, at the point of contact which is drawn, so that normal is MN. MN is the normal which is drawn, and this line, normal MN, is cut by the addendum circle. You can see the addendum circle of the wheel is cutting the normal at point K, and similarly the addendum circle of the pinion is cutting the normal at point L. So the addendum circle of the pinion is cutting at point K, and the addendum circle of the wheel is cutting at point K, and the addendum circle of the pinion is cutting that normal at point L. So the distance K to L is the length of path of contact. Okay, the distance from K to L is the length of path of contact. So how do you get this? So in order to get this distance, so what we'll be doing is, we'll be doing this construction line is drawn. So this O to N, O to N is a line which is perpendicular to the normal. Okay, similarly O to M is also a line which is perpendicular to this normal. So in order to find the distance, so this length of path of contact from K to L, okay, can be divided into two terms, from K to P and P to L. So K to P, your P is your pitch point, so is the path of approach, length of path of approach, and P to L is the length of path of recess. Now let's try to find first K to P, and then we'll try to find out from P to L. So for finding the path of approach, okay, so we'll be considering the triangle O to N and K. If you consider the triangle, okay, K N O 2, so this is the triangle. If you consider, so the distance K to N, the distance K to N, this is nothing but a right angle triangle. So you can use Pythagoras theorem and try to find out what is the length K N. So the length K N square is equal to square root of the hypotenuse from K to O2 square minus O1 n square. So using the Pythagoras theorem, you can find out what is the length k to n. And now using one more triangle, which is O2 PN. Again, this is a right angle triangle. Again, using Pythagoras theorem, you can find out what is the distance P to N. Okay, P to N. So once we know what is the distance from K to N and P to N, okay, so we can subtract K to N minus P N. So you will be getting the distance KP. Okay, so the same procedure is adopted with respect to pinion also. Okay, with respect to pinion, if you consider the triangle O1, okay, ML, O1 ML, and this is also a right angle triangle. So using Pythagoras theorem, you can find out the distance from M to L. Okay, and using one more triangle, which is O1 ML. P, using this triangle also, you can find out what is the distance from M to P. So M to L minus M to P will be knowing what is the distance from P to L. So that is how we'll try to find out the length of path of contact by adding K to P plus P to L. So it says that the contact between the pair of involute teeth begins at L and ends at begins at K and ends at L. So as I've already told you, so MN is a normal, is a common normal to the point of contact, and it is also a tangent to the base circle. So this is the normal to the point of contact, and also it is tangent to both the base circles, and it has to pass through the pinch point to satisfy the law of gearing. So the point K is the intersection of the addendum circle of the wheel and a common tangent. So point K is the intersection of the addendum circle of the wheel and the tangent. Similarly, the point L would be the intersection of the addendum circle of the pinion and the tangent. And the tangent to base circle, but it is actually the normal to the point of contact. So that we have discussed. And so what do you mean by length of contact? What is length of approach and length of recess? So it's been discussed here. Okay, so now while calculating the length of contact, we talked about the radius of the pinion is taken in terms of small letter, and the radius of the wheel is taken in terms of capital letter. And here you have O1M. Okay, so so if you talk about O1M, okay, which is the radius of the root circle of the pinion, so which is taken as just of the gear A, the pinion is taken as gear A. So similarly, you have, so here, so this O1M, okay, so O1M is given by O to P. Okay, your P is your pinch point. So the component of O to P along this OM, which is O1P into cos 5. If you do O1P into cos 5, you will get O1M. Similarly, if you want to find out O2N, so the component of O to P, along this direction, so it is O2P cos 5 will give you O2N. And why this O2N distance is required? Because because we saw that considering the triangle O2NK, okay, so using this right angle triangle for finding the distance K to N, so we'll be using the how to find out the length of this triangle. So O2N, similarly O1M. So that is why in terms of radius, in terms of radius of the pit circle has been given. So as I talked to you, you will be considering a right angle triangle, and you will be initially finding out the path of approach. Okay, so looking at this from the point of contact to point N. Okay, so KN is given by it's a right angle triangle. Okay, O to KN, so which is square root of a hypotenuse square minus the other side square. So in terms of radius, if you write radius of the addendum circle and radius of your pith circle, okay. So O2n would be radius of your pith circle into cos 5. So finally, so your Pn, okay, your Pn, it would be O2p sin 5. We'll see that, which is nothing but r sin 5. So what was discussed is this is the triangle which was discussed there. So O2nk. So we are trying to find out the distance from k to n. So k to n is nothing but square root of k O2 square minus O2n square. And here O2k is nothing but Ra square. Okay. So and O2n, as already discussed, it is your radius of the pith circle of the wheel, which is R into cos 5. So using that, and finally you need the distance from once you have obtained the distance from k to n. So this entire length k to n minus p to n. So p to n is obtained. P to n is nothing but O to p into sine phi. If you do, you'll get the component of this along this direction. Okay, sine phi. So subtracting that, you'll be able to find out the distance k to p. Okay, so that has been given here. So what is kn and what is pn, and how to obtain kp. Kp is nothing but length of path of approach, which is kn minus pn, which is square root of Ra square minus R square cos square 5, okay, minus R sine 5. Now, coming to one more triangle with respect to the pinion, okay, the same procedure will be adopted in order to find out the length of path of recess. So, with respect to the figure, so we'll be considering O1M, okay, L, O1ML. This would be the triangle which should be considered. And we are interested in finding distance from P to L. So initially considering this triangle O1M and L, so M to L we'll try to find out using Pythagoras theorem. So later, once we found out ML, so the distance P to M, okay, the distance P to M would be O1P into sine phi. So that would give you PM. So subtract one from the another, you will be able to obtain the distance from P to L, which is your length of path of recess. So that is what is done here. So they would have considered the triangle O1ML, and they'll try to find out what is ML and then PL, and subtract one from another. Okay, so here they have subtracted one from, sorry, ML they have found out, MP they have found out. To subtract one from another, you will get this equation. And finally, the length of path of contact is, you have to add length of path of approach plus length of path of recess. So if you add this, the total equation, what you get is the length of path of contact. So length of path from the beginning of engagement to the end of engagement, so the length of the line, okay, along the normal is KL. So equation for that is given here. Let's move on to the next topic, which is the length of arc of contact. So this arc of contact is the path traced by a point on the pith circle from the beginning of engagement to the end of engagement of the gear tooth. So here you can see that you have the path of contact would be from K to L. So you have two gears which have been meshed. So the first gear is represented as pinion here with center O1, and the second gear is represented as a wheel with center O2. And a common tangent which is drawn for both the root circle, which is written as MN. Apart from that, you have the pitch circle of both the gears are in contact at point P, which is your pitch point. and K to L, which is the point on the MN from the beginning of engagement, that is from beginning of engagement K to the end of engagement L. So that is the path of contact. So talking about arc of contact, it is a point on the pitch circle which traces from the beginning of engagement to end of engagement. Now you have two pitch circles here. So the one is with respect to pinion and one with respect to gear. So if you consider the pitch circle with respect to pinion, so from the beginning of engagement, so is the K. So the K which is projected on the pitch circle of the pinion, you will get it as G. So from point G to P, again try to project the point P onto the pitch circle of the pinion, which is H. So G, P, H. So that will give you the arc of contact with respect to pinion. So similarly, the arc of contact for the gear, so try to project the same point K onto the pitch circle of the wheel. So you have E. Okay, you have E here. So on the pitch circle of the wheel, so E, P, and F is nothing but the projection of L onto the pitch circle of the wheel. F. So E, P, F would be the arc of contact with respect to the wheel. Now, this entire arc of contact can be divided into two parts. That is the path of, something with respect to approach and something with respect to recess. So you can call it as arc of contact, the total length of arc of contact. So which is GPH can be split into GP plus PH, where GP is the arc of approach and P to H is the arc of recess. So in order to find out the GP as well as PH, so your GP, okay, so your GP can be taken as the arc, the path of contact, so the path of approach, so K to P. So K to P is the path of approach. So K to P divided by cos 5 divided by cos 5 will give you GP. So will give you GP. So GP is nothing but KP divided by cos 5. Similarly, P to H. So P to H, if you want. So P to L. P to L is the path of recess. So PL divided by cos 5 will give us PH. Okay. So the total GPH is the arc of approach plus arc of recess. So you can take it as KP by cos 5 plus PL by cos 5, which turns out to be KL divided by cos 5. So which is nothing but length of path of contact divided by cos 5. So which is explained in the subsequent slides. So the arc of contact is the path traced by a point on the pitch circle from the beginning to the end of engagement of a given pair of teeth, which is already I've told you. Now, arc of contact is EPF or GPH. So it is EPF with respect to wheel or GPH with respect to pinion. So now we'll be dividing that entire arc of contact into two parts. Okay, so which is GP and PH. GP and PH. GP is called the arc of approach and PH is called the arc of recess. And the angle subtended by these arcs, okay, are also called arc of, so the angle of approach and angle of recess. So for finding the length of those arcs, okay, so the length of arc of approach, which was G to P, I've already told you it is length of path of approach by cos 5. Similarly, the length of arc of recess is length of arc of path of recess divided by cos 5. So when for finding the total length of arc of contact, you just have to add them. So what you finally get is length of arc of contact is equal to length of path of contact Okay, length of path of contact divided by cos phi. Now, coming to the contact ratio, so we know a contact ratio is the minimum or the number of teeth which are in contact at any given point of time. Okay, so which is usually given by length of arc of contact divided by circular pitch. So the equations for length of arc of contact is length of path of contact divided by cos 5, we have seen. Okay, so that divided by circular pitch, which is pi times of module. So next we'll discuss about what is the interference in involute gears. Now again we'll be considering the diagram where two gears have been meshed, and we are representing the smaller gear or gear 1 as pinion and the bigger gear as wheel, which is given by the second wheel. The centers are O1 and O2, and we have the base circles, the pitch circles, as well as the addendum circles. Now, Mn is a common tangent which is drawn to the base circle of both the gears, and K to L, okay, is the path of contact, length of path of contact, and P is the pitch point. So this tangent which is drawn to the base circle should always pass through the pitch point. Now, at a particular instant, so let us say point L, okay, point L is usually the end of engagement of the which represents the end of engagement of the gear tooth, okay, which falls on the tangent MN. Now here what has been shown here is, so now if the end of engagement doesn't happen somewhere here, okay, and if you're trying to extend the end of engagement, okay, further, if you're trying to extend it further, in such cases you're trying to increase the addendum circle of the pinion. Let us say it is increased, okay, from OL to ON. So the addendum circle radius is increased from OL to ON. So this is the limiting condition. So it has been increased. So at that point of time, so the end of engagement has changed from point L to N. Okay. Similarly, the beginning of engagement earlier with the smaller radius, okay, of the pinion, it was at K. It was at K. Now, if you try to increase it, if you try to increase the addendum of the wheel, so it will happen at point M. So these are the two limiting points. These are the, you can consider them as point M and N are the limiting points. Why limiting points? Because you can see that you have drawn a tangent here. This tangent, okay, is tangent to the base circle. And these points also are intersecting at the same point. So if you try to further increase the addendum radius or of the pinion or for the wheel, so this intersection, okay, will surpass these points. Will surpass these points, and the intersection will happen behind N, or it can happen even behind this M also. And such cases, what you're trying to do is you're trying to increase the addendum radius. So this point, okay, of intersection, because you are trying to increase the addendum radius, so this the pinion addendum, okay, will try to dig into the root circle of the wheel. Here what is happening, if you further increase, okay, here it is just touching the root circle, and if you try to further increase, so what happens is it will try to dig into the root of the wheel. So in such cases the material will be removed from the wheel, and this phenomena is called interference. This can happen even by increasing the addendum radius of the wheel also. So let us say the maximum addendum radius of the wheel is from O2 to M. If you further increase, so the addendum of the wheel will try to dig into the root of the pinion, thereby removing the material or damaging the gear. So this is called as the interference. So the points M and N here are called the interference points, which means that whatever addendum you select, okay, the maximum addendum radius that you select should be equal to O1N or O2M. And also if you want to prevent interference, the condition is, so this addendum circle should always cut the tangent which is drawn. The tangent is this tangent MN drawn should always cut between these two points. So if the addendum circle is cutting the tangent in between these two points, so then we can say that there is no interference in gear. So we'll discuss few more points with respect to interference in gears. So as already discussed, we have selected two gears with center O1 and O2, and MN is a common tangent and K2L is the path of contact. And we are changing the radius of the addendum from O1L, so sorry, from O1M so with respect to this we are changing it from O1L to O1N. So we are trying to increase it. If you try to increase the addendum radius of the pinion, so what will happen? So the pinion tooth will try to dig into the root of the wheel, thereby removing certain amount of material from the wheel, so which is known as interference. So we have also talked about the point M and N are the two limiting cases, are also called interference points. So you cannot further increase the addendum radius. So in order to avoid the interference, you have to make sure that the point of contact between the two teeth will always happen on the involute profile of both the teeth. So you can also avoid interference if the addendum circle of the two mating gears, which cuts the common normal to the base circle between the point of tangency. What does this mean? So this, whatever this addendum circle, it has to cut the common normal in between the points M and N. So only then you can avoid interference. Now, we'll consider the limiting cases when the interference is just avoided. In the sense, you have taken the maximum possible radius of the pinion, the maximum possible radius of the wheel. So those two comes to point O1 to M and O1 to N. Those are called the maximum. So the distance from M to N, it represents the maximum length of path of contact. So it means that the interference is just avoided. Now, the maximum length of path of approach, okay, in such a case, the maximum length of path of approach would be from M to P, okay. Similarly, maximum length of path of recess would be from P to N. So maximum length of path of contact in such case, you just have to add both. Similarly, once you know the length of path of contact, you can find out the arc of contact by dividing the length of contact by cos phi. Now let's discuss the minimum number of teeth on the pinion to avoid interference. Let's go back to the previous diagram. So if you see this diagram again, so the maximum radius, addendum radius of the pinion is O1N, okay. So in order to avoid interference, we have to make sure that the addendum circle of the mating gear cuts the common tangent in between point M and N. So that is the condition to avoid interference. Now for finding the minimum number of teeth on the pinion which is required to avoid interference, what we'll do for this is we'll try to calculate what is the addendum of the pinion for a condition that it has to avoid interference. So the addendum of the pinion, as you can see here, is the addendum circle radius is O1N, so the the pitch circle is O1P. So if you subtract O1N minus O1P, you would get the addendum of the pinion. So we'll use the equation for the addendum of the pinion, and we'll try to represent those in terms of the teeth on the wheel as well as the pinion, and what is the minimum condition required in order to avoid interference, and we'll try to further simplify that equation for addendum of the pinion, and we'll arrive at the number
now,
of minimum number of teeth on
the minimum
pinion,
number of teeth
in order
on
to
the
avoid
pinion
interference.
To avoid interference.
So talking about this,
let's go back.
So
to the
here to derive
diagram.
That we will be considering what is the addendum
so
of the pinion. So as I told you, the addendum
again
of the pinion would be
so the maximum
ON minus OP. So but we already
radius
know what is O1
addendum
P.
Radius of the
so
pinion
O1P
is
the O1N radius.
Okay,
so
the
in order to avoid
radius
interference,
we have to
pinion
make sure that.
But how do you find out O1N?
The addendum
so
circle
we
of
have
the
to
meeting
use the cos formula for this
cuts
triangle.
The
so common tangent in
so
between
if you want
point
to find the
M and N
side
O1N.
So that is the condition
so to avoid interference.
So O1N
now for finding the minimum number of teeth
equal
on the pinion which is required
O1P
to avoid
square
interference plus PN square
so how
minus
what we'll
two
do for
this
of
is the opposite sides.
We'll try to calculate what is the
PN addendum of
as
the
well
pinion
as for condition
into cos of
the angle
to avoid
between these two sides.
So the addendum
so
of
using
the pinion
that formula,
as you can see here,
so we'll
is
try to find out what is
the
O1N.
Addendum circle radius is
O1N.
O1N.
So the addendum
minus
O1P
this
will
do
pit circle
to
is
find out
O1P.
What is the
so
addendum of
subtract
the pinion
O1N.
So this addendum of the pinion
minus O1P would get the addendum of the pinion
will be
so
we
equated
use the
to
a
standard
addendum
of
the
pinion.
Okay,
and
which is required. We'll try to represent those
avoid
in terms of the
teeth.
So that will be equated
as well
as
the
AP
pinion
to
M.
And what is the minimum condition
so
required
AP
in order
to M
avoid interference
would be
and
the
we'll try to further simplify the
addendum
of
the
pinion
for
which is
required
addendum of the pinion
in order to avoid interference.
We'll arrive at
assuming that
the number of
so where AP is
minimum
the
number
of
teeth on the pinion
okay
which is required
which
in order to avoid interference.
The addendum of the pinion of one module
so talking about
is
this
required to be
so
multiplied
here,
such
to derive
that
it avoids
we will be considering what is the addendum
so
of the pinion.
So
as I told
and
you the addendum of the pinion would be
we'll
arrive at an equation
minus OP.
The number
so
of
but
teeth
we already know what is O1P.
So O1P
so the number
is
of teeth on the pinion is taken as small
radius.
The number
okay
of
so
teeth
the radius
on the
pit circle
gear
radius
of the
wheel
pinion
is taken as capital
but
T.
How do you find out O1N?
So
just
have
to use the cos formula for this triangle.
Try to memorize
so
this diagram.
So if you want
okay
to find
the
closer
side
look
O1N
so we'll be considering
so
O1PN.
So
O1N square
O1PN
is equal to O1P square plus PN square minus
now,
2 times
so
of whatever is been discussed
has
been stated in these two points
as well as
now
PO1
will be
the cos of the
finding
angle
out what is the distance from O1
so
to
using
N
that formula
okay, in the triangle.
So we'll try to find out what is
so the using the cosine formula.
So
later,
O1N
O1N
square
N
is equal to
minus
O1P square
plus PN
square minus
2
times
out
of the opposite sides
addendum
O1
of the pinion.
So this
addendum
of the pinion
into cos of the angle between the opposite sides
will be
O1P
equated to a
so
standard addendum of the pinion
usually
okay
is your which is required pit circle radius of the pinion
to avoid
but
interference.
Okay,
so
PN
that will
be
equated
okay
to let
PN
us say
so
APN
could be
written
M
as
so AP into M
so the pit circle
radius
the
of the wheel
addendum of the pinion
into
which is sine
phi
in order
to avoid
interference
your expression
assuming
for PN
that.
So where AP is
same
the fraction
thing will be used here
okay
by
and
which
the
addendum
the
cos
of
pinion
O1
of one
PN
module
so the O1
PN
is
required
of
to be multiplied
such
so
that
simplifying
it
these all these terms
so
finally
you will arrive at
two,
and
so
simplifying that
O1N square would
arrive
at
an equation for the number of teeth on the pinion small t. So the number of teeth on the pinion is taken as small t.
Now,
the number
talking
of
about what
the
is the limiting radius of the
wheel is taken as capital T.
Addendum circle of the pinion.
So just
limiting radius
of the addendum circle of the pinion.
Try to memorize this.
So
diagram.
O1N it is that.
Okay,
so
just have
in the last slide we have
look
calculated
so
O1N
square
O1.
So
you just
have
N
to take a square root of that
okay,
so in order
N
to get O1N.
So here, after arriving at this equation, so you have
now
pit circle
so
radius is
whatever is
being discussed has been stated in
so
these two points.
Now we know that module is pit
now
circle diameter divided
we'll
by
number
of
finding
teeth
out what is the distance
so
from O1 to N.
So this
okay,
R can
be
so
the
using the cosine
formula
by 2 and
so O1N square is
this
equal
ratio capital
O1
R by
square
small
r
PN square minus 2 times
as we know that
it
for two gears to mesh properly
their
circular
pin
should be same
to cos of
so circular
the
angle
pitch
between
in
the
terms
opposite
of module
sides can
be written
as pi times
of module
so
you can even say
O1
that
P usually is
for two gears to
mesh properly
or
have
pinion,
a constant velocity
but
ratio their
circular
okay,
pin
should be
okay
same
PN
or their module
so
should be same
could be
so
written as
have a same module So the pitch circle so radius of this capital R also in terms sin of m into capital so that is by 2 your expression for P
small r also as
the same thing will be used here
by 2
and since modules are same so
the
modules
cos of
O1 Pn
well so the O1 also gets cancelled
so what you left is phi.
So this so ratio
simplifying
capital R
all these
small
terms
r can be written as
so finally you will arrive at so
O1n
square would be this equation
distance from O to n which is your maximum radius of the addendum circle of the pinion.
Now,
so as already
talking
this,
about what is the limiting radius
limiting
of the
condition or the maximum radius of the
addendum circle,
circle
of the
pinion,
limiting radius of the
so will be equated to APM.
So what is
so
APM?
O1n it is
APM
that.
APM
so
is nothing but
the last slide
we
have calculated
O1
square. So
it
is again
take a square root of that.
We'll assume that
in order
APM
to
is the
O1
limiting
n
condition. So here
of the addendum
after
of the
arriving at this
so
equation,
where AP is the fraction
so
by which
pitch circle radius
standard
in terms of module
of one module for the pinion
so,
is multiplied.
Now we know that
okay,
module is
pitch circle diameter
divided
so
by
in order to avoid
number of
teeth.
This is the limiting condition.
So this
okay.
R can
so
be
that is the
case.
You just
return
this
as
being
the
condition.
Two,
so we'll
and,
be equating since this is
ratio
capital R
by
a
small r
for the
as we know that
to avoid
for
interference
two gears
to
mesh
so
properly
and this gives the
circular pitch
for
the same addendum
so
of the pinion
pitch in
so
terms of
equating
this
to
as
pi times of module
so upon
so
equating
that
for two
okay,
gears
so,
to
so this
mesh
not
properly
addendum,
or
it is
basically
the
elasticity
radius
so
of the
addendum
circle
pitch should
so
be
if we want the
same
addendum
or their module
so addendum
is
O1
so once
n minus
same
module
p
okay
O1p okay.
from the
so
figure
you can express
so
this capital R all R also
so
in terms
O1p
of
is nothing but
the
radius of the
and small
r
also as
pitch circle diameter
of the
pinion
since
okay.
modules are
pitch
same
circle
so
of
module
gets
cancelled
so,
as well as
so that
two
radius
gets
can be written
as
what
you left
is
so
for
so this
ratio
capital R by small r
okay.
can be written as
for the simplifying this
t.
equation you'll get it in this form
so you'll be getting the
distance
so now
from
simplifying the same
equation
your
maximum
radius
the
of the
small
t small
t
is the number
of pinions
on the
so as already told
pinion.
You this
okay.
number of
limiting
condition
pinion.
Or the maximum radius
so finally
of
the,
so the
number
of teeth circle
of the
pinion
okay
so
will
be
equated
in order
to
avoid
APM.
Interference so
yes.
what is
APM
2 times of
APM
is
nothing
AP
but that and
divided
the
by square root of 1 plus g
so it is
okay.
the, again it's
so this
we'll assume
g
that
gear
APM
ratio.
Is the
so
limiting
g
condition
plus 2 into sine square phi minus
the
addendum
of
the pinion
so g is
so where
AP
is the fraction
by
which
small
t a standard addendum
of
one module for
the
pinion
is
multiplied
diameter of the
pinion
in order to avoid interference
so in order to avoid interference
so
the
limiting
so
this
is the
condition
and this equation
okay.
you have to
so if that is the case
in mind
you just
this
being
the
so
condition
the
minimum
so
number of
teeth
on the pinion
this is the
in order
condition
to avoid
limiting
condition
is obtained by using
for
this
the
equation.
Pinion to avoid interference so and this gives the equation for addendum of the pinion so we'll be equating this to this equation so upon equating okay so this is not the addendum it is basically the radius of the addendum circle so if we want the addendum so addendum is O1 n minus O1p okay O1p from the figure so O1p is nothing but the radius of the pitch circle diameter of the pinion okay pitch circle of the pinion so that radius can be written as mt by 2 so further simplifying okay further simplifying this equation you will get it in this form so now simplifying the same equation for the small t is the number of teeth on the pinion okay number of teeth on the pinion so finally so the number of teeth on the pinion which is required in order to avoid interference is 2 times of AP divided by square root of 1 plus G okay so this G is your gear ratio so G plus 2 into sine square phi minus 1 so G is capital T by small t you can even take it as pitch circle diameter of the wheel by pitch circle diameter of the pinion so this is the condition and this equation you have to keep in mind so the minimum number of teeth on the pinion in order to avoid interference is obtained by using this equation